While working in a drawing, it's only natural that we will need to modify the elements we have created to fit properly in the drawing. It goes without saying that AutoCAD provides us with the necessary tools for this purpose. The first tool we will learn is the copy tool. There are quite a few occasions that copying certain elements instead of drawing them over again is easier and also saves us time. To give you a fuller picture of the way this tool can be used, two simple drawings have been created. As you can see, in the first example, there's a room's floor plan. In this room, a bed along with a night table have already been created. However, I want one night table in each side of the bed. Instead of drawing an identical night table on the left side, it's way easier to just copy the one on the right side using the copy tool. The copy command can be found in both the Modify menu and the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, we can type the word copy in the command line and press Enter to activate it. Since we can type every AutoCAD tool and command in the command line, I will not refer to this way of activating the tools again in the future. As soon as the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the item I wish to copy. I will select the night table and then press Enter. Next, I need to specify the base point, namely, the point which I will copy the object from. In this case, the base point needs to be set to the upper right corner of the table, so I will open the snaps list and make sure that the endpoint snap is active. Then, I will click somewhere in the drawing area to close the list, and I will set the base point to this particular endpoint by clicking on it. Now, another message prompts me to specify the second point which the table will be copied to. The point I'm going to copy the table to is the bed's upper left endpoint. So I will click on it and move the cursor away. Notice that a copy has been created, but the command is still active and I can continue creating copies of this object. In this example, I do not need to create more copies, so I will exit the command by pressing Escape. As you may have noticed, I can create copies in random places or in certain places. In case I need to copy an object in a certain distance, I can do that easily too. It's time to move on to the second example, where a rounded rectangle has been created. In the upper left corner of the rectangle, there is a circle. Let's say I want to create three more circles, one in every corner of the rectangle. The required distances of the circle centers are shown in the drawing. Instead of using the circle tool three more times to create the identical circles, I am going to copy the existing one. Hence, I will activate the copy command, select the circle, and then press Enter. After selecting the object I want to copy, I have to specify the base point. Before I click anywhere in the drawing, I will open the snaps list and make sure that the center snap is active. Once I do that, I will close the list and then I will set the base point to the center of the circle by clicking on it. Since I intend to copy the circle horizontally, I'm going to activate the ortho mode too. Next, I have to specify the second point which the circle will be copied to. Since I know the distance between the circle centers, I will move the cursor to the right and type the number 24 to specify the direction and the distance of the second point. The moment I press Enter, the circle was copied. As before, the command remains active, so I will press Escape to exit the command. At this point, I should mention that I can select more than one object to copy at the same time. So, to create the remaining two circles, I will activate the copy command again, select the two circles, and press Enter. Then, I will set the base point to the center of a circle. In this example, it doesn't matter which circle center I choose. Then I will move the cursor vertically and type the number 46 to define the direction and the distance again. I will press Enter to create the copies and Escape to exit the command. The result is exactly how I wanted it to be.